Why 99.9% of sperm don't make it. Imagine 300 million tiny, determined swimmers, each one a potential life blasting off into the unknown. It's an epic journey, a microscopic mad dash against impossible odds. But here's the brutal truth. Within mere minutes, a staggering 99.9% of them are dead, vanished. What force annihilates almost every single one? Today, we're going to chase the ultimate survivors through what might just be the most lethal assault course on Earth. It's a biological gauntlet, a high-stakes race where only one can win. Ready? Let's dive in and witness this incredible microscopic battle for life. Hook. 99.9% failure. Sounds absolutely brutal, doesn't it? Yet this incredible, almost inconceivable culling is precisely why you and I exist. It's not a flaw in the system, it's the system itself, a masterclass in natural selection. Each stage of the female reproductive tract isn't just a pathway, it's a meticulously custom-built death trap, engineered over millennia to wipe out entire armies of sperm in mere seconds. Evolution, in its infinite wisdom, keeps tightening the screws, refining this ruthless filtering process. Stick with us until the very end, and you'll discover the single, ingenious chemical trick that allows one triumphant sperm to slam the door shut on every rival, ensuring its victory. Section 1. The Acid Gauntlet. Our journey begins with the first immediate hurdle. The vagina's famously hostile pH of 4.5. To put that in perspective, it's about as acid as tomato juice or even some cleaning products. This isn't just an unpleasant swim. It's a chemical attack designed to utterly dissolve the delicate outer membranes of these microscopic cells. Most sperm, unprepared for this onslaught, are instantly shredded, their cellular integrity compromised beyond repair. But evolution has a trick up its sleeve for the survivors. A select few come equipped with tiny alkaline droplets called prostosomes, which they strategically release to neutralize the acidity in a minuscule bubble around their tails. No coating? Death is swift, often in under 30 seconds. Right here at the very starting line, almost half of our initial launch crew is already gone, flushed away by this acidic tide. Section 2. The cervix maze. Next up, an even more cunning challenge, the cervix. On most days, this gateway is sealed by a formidable wall of mucus, thick and impenetrable, like trying to swim through cold peanut butter. It's an absolute dead end for any would-be adventurer. However, during ovulation, a surge of estrogen miraculously transforms this barrier, making it thinner and more watery, a brief window of opportunity. But don't be fooled, it's still laced with killer proteins called defensins, ready to ensnare the unwary. The truly elite sperm, those with perfect form and unwavering direction, find themselves navigating microscopic channels just 2 microns wide. Anything less than a perfectly straight line, any wobbly, inefficient swimmer gets hopelessly glued in place, trapped in the viscous network. Millions perish here, stuck in a biological quicksand. Another 100 million vanish, their journey ending in a sticky, protein-rich maze. Section 3. Uterine Cramp Stampede. Congratulations, survivors. You've made it to the uterus. But don't get comfortable. This is where things get truly chaotic. The uterus now unleashes a series of turbocharged contractions, powerful muscular spasms that ripple through its walls in random, unpredictable directions. Picture trying to surf a washing machine filled with ball bearings. That's the kind of turbulent, disorienting chaos these microscopic swimmers face. The lucky few manage to surf these powerful currents, propelling them forward. But the unlucky ones? They're smashed against the uterine walls, or worse, they collide head-on with the female's immune system's vigilant patrols. These specialized immune cells, not recognizing the sperm as anything other than foreign invaders, treat them like bacteria, launching a full-scale attack. They are engulfed, neutralized, and eliminated. At this stage, the numbers dwindle dramatically. Only about 1 in 1,000 of the original cohort clears this violent immunological gauntlet. Section 4. Fallopian fork in the road. Having survived the uterine chaos, our intrepid sperm face a cruel twist of fate, a literal fork in the road. The uterus leads to 2 fallopian tubes, but only one of them holds the precious egg. This means, by pure chance, roughly half of the remaining sperm will march resolutely down a dead-end tunnel, their heroic efforts ultimately in vain. It's nature's brutal lottery, cutting the field down to a mere few thousand. But for the fortunate ones who chose correctly, the journey isn't over, it's just getting more intense. While they swim, these sperm undergo a crucial transformation called capacitation, which enhances their motility and prepares them for the final push. Meanwhile, the egg's surrounding support cells begin to leak a potent chemical signal, progesterone. This hormone acts like a beacon, opening specialized cat sperm calcium channels on the tails of nearby sperm. The effect is dramatic. These channels supercharge their flagella, turning the survivors into hyperactive, frantic torpedoes, swimming with renewed vigor directly towards their ultimate prize. Section 5. Zona Hell Week. Now the ultimate defense, the egg itself. It's not just floating freely, it's protected by multiple layers. First, a loose outer layer of follicle cells called the corona radiata, which sperm must push through. But the real challenge lies beneath, a thick glycoprotein sugar mesh known as the zona pellucida. This isn't just a barrier, it's an intelligent lock. A sperm must first bind precisely to specific receptors on this zona. Only then can it trigger the acrosome reaction, essentially firing an enzyme grenade from its head. These powerful enzymes are designed to bore a tiny, precise hole through the zona, creating a tunnel for entry. But timing, as they say, is everything. Fire too early, and the precious enzymes drift off, wasted. Fire too late, and a rival might sneak through your painstakingly created tunnel. Fewer than a dozen sperm, out of the initial 300 million, managed to nail this incredibly complex and precise maneuver. Section 6. The 1 second door bolt. After all that, it comes down to a single, triumphant moment. The instant one victorious sperm finally fuses with the egg's plasma membrane, a spectacular biological event unfolds. Zinc atoms flash outwards like a burst of paparazzi bulbs, signaling the egg's immediate, irreversible transformation. This zinc flash triggers a cascade of changes that rapidly harden the zona pellucida, effectively turning that sugar mesh into an impenetrable brick wall. This crucial mechanism is called the block to polyspermy, preventing any other sperm from entering and ensuring that only one set of paternal DNA combines with the eggs. It's the ultimate 1 second door bolt. One winner, 299,999,999 losers. And that, in a nutshell, is precisely why the failure rate for these microscopic marvels sits at an astounding 99.9%. Like learning why your own biology is smarter and more dramatic than any video game? Then hit that subscribe button and join our community. Catch our next episode, where we'll explore another incredible biological marvel, how an embryo cleverly hacks the mother's immune system for 9 months straight, ensuring its survival. Conclusion. In the grand scheme of life, almost every single sperm cell is, paradoxically, designed to fail. This isn't a design flaw, it's a feature. Each lethal filter, the searing acid, the suffocating mucus, the chaotic uterine contractions, the precise chemical timing, the impenetrable egg defenses, serves a singular, vital purpose: to relentlessly shape and select the most fit genome. It ensures that only the most robust, the most perfectly formed, and the most determined single cell reaches the egg, carrying the genetic blueprint for a new person. The true miracle here isn't just speed or sheer numbers. It's the incredible resilience and precision required to survive a gauntlet that kills 99.9% and still, against all odds, deliver absolute perfection. It's the ultimate battle for life, and every one of us is a testament to its success.